The last thing to cover in the memory and storage topic is compression. So compression is all relating to file sizes and trying to cut down a file size. So maybe it's obvious, maybe it's not, but the file size is the number of binary digits required to store it. Is it 5 bits? Is it 1 million bits? Is it 2 billion bits? Often we express those bigger numbers in kilobytes and gigabytes and terabytes. That is our file size, how much binary data is needed to store it. And compression is trying to reduce this file size. Again, maybe it's obvious, but we need to verbalize why this is a good thing. Why is it a good thing to have a smaller file size? It's a really common exam question. Well, there are three main points. The first point is it takes up less capacity of your primary storage and your secondary storage. So it means the actual file is taking up less space. This means we've got more space available to store other files. If we reach our limit of secondary storage, for example, we reach our capacity, we've got to either delete things or buy a new storage device. So it's preferable if our files are as small as possible. Another benefit is we can transfer files quicker over a network. This is both in terms of uploading a file, but also downloading a file. If we have lots of images on our web pages, it will take longer for a user to download. YouTube will have compressed the video you're watching right now so that it arrives at your computer faster. It will arrive at your computer faster because it's got less binary data to have to transfer. And linked to this point, but is a separate point, is that if a file size is smaller, it will take up less bandwidth compared to the bigger version of it. So bandwidth we'll look at in a future video and we'll define it properly. But I like to think of bandwidth as like a cake or a pie, where the more of it we're using up, the less there is for somebody else to use, because it is something which has to get shared out. So there are two types of compression, lossy and lossless. Lossy is a category of algorithms which reduce the file size by selectively deleting some of the data. And this is the most obvious way to compress a file, just delete some of it. That will definitely save space by deleting some of the data. How it does this will depend on the exact algorithm. There are loads of different ones for images and sound and videos, but they'll try and remove data which is not as noticeable to the user. But what it does mean crucially is that the original version before the compression was applied is different from the compressed version. We've deleted some data, therefore it is different, and we can't go back to our original, it's gone. We use lossy compression with videos and images and audio all the time. Here is a photo taken. It was 18.1 megabytes when I downloaded it. I apply some lossy compression on it, quite heavy lossy compression, and it goes down to 372 kilobytes, which is a massive drop off in file size. However, the big disadvantage of applying lossy compression is there will often be an impact on the quality. So we can see here the quality of this image has gone down. We've got slightly weird banding in the sky here. The actual elephant and the grass and ground look okay, but it's had to obviously do some deletion with this gradient, which has caused this dodgy appearance. Now, this is quite heavy compression. If I did less heavy compression, I'd get a bigger file size, but it would look less noticeable. Most images you see are compressed using lossy compression, and most do look okay, but they're not quite as good as the original. If we compress audio using lossy compression, it won't sound quite as good as the original, but we may want that in order to get a smaller file size. If it takes us a long time to download our music, we might prefer to have it sounding a little bit less good, but it loads a lot faster. So it's a trade-off between quality and file size here. Now, lossless compression, interestingly, doesn't seem to have any disadvantages immediately, because lossless compression rearranges the way the file is stored to make it be more efficient. The word efficient is often overused in computer science, but it's trying to maximize what you have, or in this way, minimize the amount of storage we are using. Like there are loads of different lossy algorithms, there are loads of different lossless algorithms which work in different ways, which we don't have to know for GCSE, but just to give you a slight sense of what this is like, there are certain efficiency improvements we can make. For example, if I've got, say, an image which has a few pixels back to back, but if I've got repeated pixels which are the same color, maybe I've got, since I'm using it here, red, 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 green. Well, I'm storing this red pixel 4 times in a row. Wouldn't it be better if I instead told the computer I've got 4 lots of red followed by 1 lot of green? That would potentially save storage space because I'm not storing the red pixel 4 times. I'm just telling it I've got four and I've also got one lot of green. So that would potentially save file size without deleting any data, because crucially, lossless does not involve any data being lost. That's its main benefit. The quality is completely unaffected because nothing gets deleted. The key drawback is it's not quite as effective as lossy. It will not decrease it by the same amount that lossy would. Now, one really, really important point is lossless could be used on images and audio and video, but so could lossy. Lossless must be used on text files or indeed programs. And that really means that we can't use lossy on text files. We can't use lossy on programs. Programs contain code, either the sort of source code you see when you're writing Python or ERL or the binary. Text files contain text, right? And the reason why we can't use lossy on these two types is because there's essentially nothing in most files which can be deleted without affecting the meaning. I can't just go ahead and cross out some letters in my text and just delete those letters. It's going to completely change the meaning of my text. So we can't use lossy on text or programs. You have to use lossless. On images, though, you could choose to use lossless. So here are the ones I just showed you. One on the left is the original. One on the right is compressed using lossy compression. Just for comparison, well, I could apply a lossless algorithm to the original. And you can see it has reduced file size. It's gone from 18 megabytes to 6 megabytes. That's nowhere near as much of a reduction as the lossy algorithm did. But there should be no difference in quality between these two left-hand images. You could spend hours playing spot the difference and you should never, ever, ever see a difference, because lossless does not involve deleting anything. It's just been cleverer about how it stores stuff in the file.